want to work on crossing midline and have trouble with it. So we came up with a couple of simple exercises or simple activities that you can do that will hopefully help with that. And the first thing is really simple. Like, I have a bunch of mini baby animals, but you can do, you can use whatever. You can use Legos, little balls, beads, whatever you have. And I would have, the child is more independent, have just put them on one side of their body, and they can be sitting. They can be sitting on the floor. Grab one, move it to the next side. You can do it as a family activity and have both parents sitting on either side of the child and say, take it from mommy, give it to daddy. To make it more difficult, you can say, okay, mommy will give it to you and put it down here, and then give it to daddy, and daddy can put his hand up and say, hey, reach, give it to me right here. So what you don't want is for your child to pick up the object with one hand, switch in the middle, and put it back this way. So either both hands or one hand all the way across. So, and you can do this too. Actually, this was not intended, but this is good. Take it up from the floor, put it in a container. You can have a bucket, okay? And the same thing with the other hand. Or you can have something on the higher container, put it on the floor, or higher container, put it on the other side. Okay, so you wanna do it either with both hands or one hand. The idea is to cross the midline of the body. If your child is a little bit more advanced, you can try going, put it behind you, take it from the other side. And this involves more trunk rotation, oblique and transverse abdominal muscles. The second thing you can do is if you have a pool noodle, a yardstick, a PVC pipe, a very large abacus, if the parent is holding this, or if you have it stretched like between the two chairs, and this is more if your kid is having difficulty with this, to have them go across the line and just move, you know, five rings this way, five rings the other way. And you can have, I mean, you can make it as simple or as hard as complicated as can be. It could be a simple string with rings made out of pipe cleaners. You can move beads on the string. This is pretty simple. You can have them move it back and forth. Of course, do the same thing with both arms. The next thing is actually one of my little kids' dad gave me the idea, and it's with using either a pool noodle or something longer to use both hands at the same time. Are you going to play either a balloon or a beach ball? We're going to have a beach ball. And you want the child to use both hands and hit it. Okay? Alright, so that's perfect. And you can throw it from different angles and have the child do it that way. You can do it in standing. You can have a family thing. Okay, don't let the balloon touch the floor, and have you and your child try to keep the balloon in the air by tapping it. The next thing is more for the legs. A lot of the times kids have trouble sidestepping. So I would have them try sidestepping, and sometimes to guide them. Can you see my feet? Okay. I can, if the child is really having trouble and they tend to turn their feet and go like this and then turn back and come like that, I try to give them my hands, and I even put stickers on their sneakers or on their shoes and just say, point the sticker towards me, and I would hold their hands and kind of guide them this way. Or you can do, point the stickers towards the wall or towards the pool noodle, and then you will sidestep with them. Okay? So, simple. Eventually, what you would like for your child to be able to do is they can do this, you want them to try to jump over. And it doesn't have to be a noodle. It could be a line taped on the floor or a string, snake, whatever you have, a little cable. This is harder, and it's going to be more difficult, so I wouldn't start with that. I would start with stepping over or stepping alongside something. I'm going to grab this yard stick because that's going to be much easier. So if you were to tape a line on the floor, you can have the child kind of just slide over that. Last thing, and hopefully the most fun, is you can make one of these. This is, I borrowed from my daughter. So the simplest activity with this would be to do big circles. What you don't want is circles just on one side of the body. You want the child, and you can put him in front of the mirror.
Yeah.
Going this way. You can have him do it with both hands. Eventually, if you can do an infinity sign, you can call it sunglasses or sideways figure eight. And the same thing with the other hand. This is probably the most complex movement out of all the things I went over right now. So hopefully those will keep you busy. And good luck practicing. Bye.